Okay, so in this video tutorial, I'm going to go through the contents of the backpack case for the Canon XC15. The Canon XC15 is the camera we're going to use to produce our projects this semester because we have 10 of them. And I think you're going to see that they're pretty fun to shoot with. It's important for me to go through this with you because there are certain items that are in this bag at the moment that automatically come with the camera when you check it out from the CER. And then there's other items that you have to specifically request to include in your checkout. And I'm going to go through them here so that you can see what the contents are one by one and sort of explain what they're for. I'm going to create a corresponding document that goes alongside with this video so you can, when you reserve your equipment, you know what to get. Okay, so what you see here are the contents of the backpack that I had up here just a minute ago. Some of these items by default come with the camera when you check it out from the equipment room, but some of these things you should request as part of your equipment checkout request. So starting from the sort of the key items that are going to be in the bag when you check out the camera, you have the camera itself, the Canon XC15. You have to the right of it, this lens hood, which clicks onto the front of the camera, two batteries, at least there should be at least two batteries in it. Additionally, you have a viewfinder that clips on to the LCD screen on the XC15. Up on the top left is an AC adapter. You'll notice that the camera doesn't come with a charger. This is not a mistake, because you charge the batteries. There are chargers in the CER. We use them for the battery farm to make sure that batteries that are going out are fully charged. But the AC adapter, when plugged into the camera, when the camera is powered off and there's a battery in the body of the camera, it will charge the battery for you. So you're gonna charge the battery inside the camera. Items that have to be specifically requested and added to your kit. I think that these are things that you should check out every time you take a camera. They include the XLR audio module that's used to provide professional audio inputs over XLR and the cable that connects that module to the camera. The camera itself has a mini jack 3.5 millimeter little plug for external microphones, like a DSLR would. But there are limitations to these kinds of interfaces. The audio module is good for getting really, really high quality audio going directly into camera, which is the audio that you're hearing recorded right now coming from my studio microphone plugged in to an XC15. On the top, there is a small flat screen LED light. Now, these don't throw a lot of light, but they're great for if you're holding the camera in the hand and you're shooting things that are close up and you need a little bit of a punch of light. These lights work with the same batteries that the NX5s do, the Sony NP4 batteries. Make sure that if you are going to check out this little light panel, that you have the appropriate batteries for the panel and that you have a charger for the panel. If you don't have that, you're going to have trouble using this little LED light. It's great, it's useful, but if you don't have the light, you're going to have a hard time. To the right of the light, you'll see this sort of thing that looks like a Y. This item is a hot shoe adapter that essentially allows you to use the hot shoe on the camera and mount multiple peripherals on top of it. The audio module uses the hot shoe on top of the camera in order to mount to the top of the camera. But if, for example, you wanted to use the audio module and the light, or you wanted to use an external microphone and a light, you only have one hot shoe on top of the camera, and this piece of equipment expands your capacity from one hot shoe mount to three, and it's just a useful thing to have. As far as external microphones go, there are two microphones that are shown right here. The one on the top is sort of a lower quality microphone that was purchased, that came with the camera when it was purchased. It has a barcode on it. I believe you have to recommend, you have to specifically request that you have it. It works. It's not as high quality as the one that's just below it, which is a very directional microphone that is made by a company called Marantz, which is a much more professional outfit. It's a really high quality mic. It connects to the camera via a 3.5 millimeter jack without the audio module. It just plugs directly into the camera. It runs on AAA batteries. But actually, both of these microphones run on batteries. So before you check the camera out, you want to make sure that you either have additional extra batteries available for that microphone, or you have a charger, or you have some idea of how you're going to power this microphone. Because these microphones are condenser microphones, they require power in order to function. And because they're not plugging into the camera using the audio module, there's no phantom power being provided to them. That power is only provided in the form of a battery. So if you sign out this these microphones and plug them into the XV15 and you don't have batteries for them, you're not going to get any sound. To the left there of the camera, there's a little square box that has a snap on it. That square box contains filters. These filters screw onto the front of the camera. There are three filters that are in the camera that are very useful for shooting. The one of them is a UV protector, which is just a piece of plain glass. My advice is to take that plain glass UV protector and put it on the lens, on front of the lens of the camera, as soon as you take it out of the CER. This way, a very inexpensive UV protector will be in front of the glass of the lens, which is very expensive, and not the glass of the lens itself. In addition, there is a one-stop neutral density filter, which is useful for lowering the intensity of light. That neutral density filter combined with the internal neutral density filter built into the XC15 will be very useful if you're shooting outside or if you're trying to achieve a narrow depth of field while shooting an interview, for example. Apply light the scene with plenty of light, initiate the neutral density filter to lower the intensity or the brightness of the image, and then you turn your iris up. And the more your iris is open, the narrower your depth of field. So that's how you're going to get that nice sharp foreground with that fuzzy, blurry background that people like to see so much, especially in the movies. So as I said, I'm going to be including or attaching to this video an itemized list of these pieces of equipment. So when you reserve an XC15 to take it out from the CER, my advice is to make sure that all of these items are in the bag. If they're not, you're going to be missing a tool when you're out in the field shooting your project, and we don't want that. I hope this has been helpful. I'll see you in the next video.